Have you ever imagined how your daily interaction with technology could look like some years from now? Imagine your future home, your future office, or even interfaces within public spaces. What will be the next thing after screens, smart speakers, etc.? Will our interaction with technology become even more intuitive? Will we be able to interact with it as we do with our human fellows today? Let me take you on a little journey to learn more about one specific new interface which could fundamentally change how we interact with our technological environment. Well, I'm Andrea, and I'm excited at Birgit's and my paper got accepted for this year's International Conference on Persuasive Technology. As we all need to adapt a little these days, I'm happy to give my presentation virtually, as all the other references do as well. When I just mentioned this future interface, I refer to social robots. Birgit and I aim to learn about the potential benefits over conventional devices. The title of our paper gives a first glimpse of what we've done in detail. We called our paper Expressive Social Robot or Tablet on the benefits of embodiment and nonverbal expressivity of the interface for a smart environment. Let me tell you what's behind. The industry has been giving us the idea of futuristic robotical user interfaces for quite a while already. Within the last couple of years, they introduced several home robots. On the one hand, these can be used in a similar way as smart speakers, for example. Meaning, we could ask our robot friend for the news, the weather, to play some music, etc. But beyond that, social robots are intended to proactively support our daily lives and routines by taking care of our needs. By offering additional modalities as embodiment and emotional expressivity, communication channels could become way richer than we currently know. Besides robots for the general population, there are also concepts for specific target groups as the elderly. In this case, technology focuses even more on support, for example by providing reminders and proactive health suggestions, or by simply bringing some joy. Although many of such robot companions are quite developed already and indeed expected to positively impact human-technology interaction, the actual benefits of having an embodied and expressive user interface have hardly been researched so far. With our study, we want to shed a little light on this. So, what exactly did we do? We compared three different interaction devices with specific modalities within a smart office setting. Our participants sat at a table and were assigned some basic office work to simulate a real office situation. The respective interaction device was placed next to them and provided interruptions on a regular basis to remind them of their physical well-being. I guess you all agree that not only elderly people can well use such support, but all of us could profit from this within our busy everyday life. The interruptions were initiated by the experimenter in a visit of OS setting, meaning they were initiated manually. For the participants, however, it seemed as if they were interacting directly with an autonomous system, especially as they couldn't see the experimenter. Overall, such interruptions happened three times during the session. Firstly, participants had to do some guided neck relaxations, secondly, to drink a glass of water, and thirdly, they were asked to walk a few steps within the room. This practical part took about 15 minutes. Afterwards, everyone had to fill a few questionnaires on their experience. As interaction devices, we chose an iPad mini and a social robot Reity. The iPad served as a control group to represent how we currently interact with smart environments. When it comes to proactive suggestions today, hints are usually given via push notifications to a smartphone or tablet screen. Such a device is neither embodied nor capable of emotional expressions. Reity, however, is an embodied social robot with the ability to express non-verbal emotions by, for example, smiling, moving its ears, or tilting its head. We used Reity for two different conditions. One time without showing emotional expressions, one time with. For each device's interruptions, exactly the same wording was used, but communicated differently. In the tablet condition, the hints were announced and shown as regular push notifications in text form. The neutral social robot spoke the words via the integrated text-to-speech function while only moving its lips. The expressive one additionally showed several non-verbal expressions, for example, smile, wink, and head tilt. So So the key question we wanted to solve in our contribution was whether the different interaction devices would affect the user's ratings. As already said, research in this space is rather rare, and a few existing findings are not unanimous. Due to this, we had to pose open research questions instead of concrete hypotheses. Based on previous research, we wanted to find out whether the three examined interfaces would differ in terms of usability, perceived workload, social perception, evaluation of the interaction, or in terms of their overall suitability. Each research question was assessed by a different questionnaire. Alright, let's have a look at the results. What you can see here are the users' ratings within their assigned condition for each research question. We could find significant differences between the experimental conditions, indicated here in red. As this figure may be a bit overwhelming, let's go through it one after the other. First of all, in terms of usability, we can see that the tablet is rated as significantly more usable than both social robots. This could be due to the fact that humans currently are simply much more used to handling a tablet than a robot. However, the fact that the usability ratings of all three groups are in the upper 20% of the scale indicates that the robot is easy to handle as well. The perceived workload was measured on a different scale than the others. That's why we need to switch to the right-hand side axis now. Here we can see a marginally significant difference between a tablet and the expressive robot. This means participants interacting with the latter had to cope with a higher load while working on the office task. Meanwhile, this doesn't apply for the neutral robot, which doesn't differ significantly from any other condition. However, its rating is close to the tablet's, indicating that the higher workload wasn't due to the robot itself, but rather due to its additional movements in the expressive condition. In general, it also needs to be mentioned here that the average perceived workload was very low across all three conditions, especially given the fact that this was an office task. So let's check on the next research question. As you can see, the social perception of both robots is rated significantly higher than the one of the tablet. In detail, this scale consists of three subscales: warmth, discomfort, and competence. As we couldn't find significant differences on the competence subscale, warmth and discomfort seem to be crucial here and provide further insights. Both robots were rated as warmer than the tablet, but the tablet led to less discomfort during the interaction. Just to make sure, you need to be aware that a low value in discomfort is positive in this case. But anyway, after having inverted the subscale, the result on the overall scale shows that the tablet's better performance regarding discomfort couldn't compensate for its disadvantage in terms of warmth. Fourth research question, the evaluation of the interaction. Again, the expressive social robot outperformed the tablet here. However, this doesn't apply for its neutral version. This scale also consists of subscales, in this case, enjoyableness and usefulness. There were no significant differences found on the latter, but on the subscale enjoyableness. On this one, we can see a greater experience joy when interacting with the expressive robot, which probably was the main factor here. Last but not least, we couldn't find significant differences in terms of this device's overall suitability central user interface. Well, I guess this is kind of understandable after just having seen that every condition showed individual advantages. And if we now have a final look at the overall results, it's interesting to see that we couldn't find any significant differences between the two robot conditions for any research question. This indicates that an interface's embodiment has a larger impact on the user rating than its capability to express emotions, at least in the context of smart environments. Yeah, let's wrap it up. What have we done to learn about the benefits of an interface's additional modalities, and what are our takeaways? We did a study within a smart office setting to compare our three conditions, which differed in embodiment and expressivity. While the tablet performed better in terms of usability and perceived workload, the social robots seem to have a clear advantage when it comes to social perception and the interaction itself. Especially when aiming at social interaction, what we usually do in the context of smart environments, social robots could indeed bring great value. More research is needed for sure, especially for being able to further reduce social robots' current weaknesses. But all in all, we regard this interface as a very promising one. I very much hope I could raise your interest in our research topic, and both Birgit and I am happy to answer your questions on this. Also, please find further details in our paper, which can be accessed through the link shown here. Many thanks for your attention. Have a great day and stay safe.